We're gonna have to reinforce Eli.
Calling it reinforcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we are going to be talking about the UTS-15, 12-gauge shotgun, or as you may know it better, the SG-8 Punisher. One of the many tools available to you from democracy's arsenal if you make the most important decision of your life and join the Helldivers. Smells like freedom. If you have been grinding Helldivers 2 in your free time as well, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. You're gonna like it here. We do a lot of gun breakdowns and stuff like this, and we never get into politics. If you don't know why that's funny, welcome to the channel. Anyhow, I don't get much free time these days. I've kind of got a few things going on, but when I do get a couple minutes free, I love blowing off some steam and playing the new game Helldivers 2 with some of my friends. One of the earliest shotguns I got in the game was the SG-8 Punisher, and I honestly still kind of run it sometimes. It's slept on. It's a good fucking gun. But I couldn't help but notice it bore striking resemblance to the UTS-15 12-gauge shotgun. I don't think it's really a stretch to say that this was obviously what the developers modeled that gun on. It's got a couple variants in the game, the SG-8 Punisher, the SG-8 Slugger, I think, which is like a variant that, you know, shoots slugs. But as soon as I started playing with it in the game, I noticed two things. One, it reminded me how cool these things look, and two, it reminded me I don't own a UTS-15, and I need to correct that. So I bought it, and it is a massive piece of shit. First off, what is it and why does it look like this? I mean, this thing's a bulky fucking shotgun. Well, it is a dual tube fed pump action shotgun. What does that mean? Well, you see these two little things here? This is where you can load the shotgun in two distinct tubes that go up along the sides of the gun above the barrel, which is kind of cool. It's a neat feature because this little lever here allows you to switch between the tubes, meaning if I wanted to run slugs in this and buckshot on this side, I could easily do that. Or if you wanted to go flechettes on this side and dragon's breath on this side, because you can't enforce the Geneva Convention when you're on fire, you can do that. But those two tubes lead into our chamber here that then feeds into the gun, and you are ready to spread managed democracy one round of 12 gauge at a time. Now, spreading managed democracy isn't all about smashing a couple bugs. Somewhere in your distinguished combat career, you might find yourself up against the automaton threat. No, this isn't literally just a bust from Terminator. Look, if the devs can get away with it, so can I. And since we spoiled you a little bit on the gyrojet, we don't have ballistic high speed here, but we do have Eli with our high speed.
It's like the Walmart version.
Opening up a can of Liberty in 3, 2, 1. Oh, crap.
He dead. He dead.
That'll do it. If only it worked that well in the game. That is no longer a threat to Super Earth. That's metal as fuck. Oh, wow.
Dude, and the cords are what ripped it together?
It's like a bolo. It almost came forward a little bit in the front.
That fucking cool shit.
That's gnarly. Here's a piece. That's like a piece of neck.
Where's his dentures at?
His teeth are the same color as these fucking rocks.
These are actually human bones.
I'm finding like other pieces of jaw out here that aren't that one.
This would be the best place to just hide a skeleton. It's just out here at the ranch.
So Helldivers is for sale. You can go on Steam and buy it right now. But you know what really sucks? Is that your personal information is out on the internet, available to buy right now. Data brokers out there will sell your personal information to scammers, spammers, or anybody else who might want to target you. Your full name, address, health records, or your relatives. It's all out there on the internet. That's why I personally use Aura, the sponsor of today's video. Aura shows me what data brokers are selling my information and automatically submits opt-out requests on my behalf. Not only does this cut down on the spam you get, but it also can help protect you from hackers that can get into your personal information, your social media accounts, bank accounts, whatever. Especially if you just saw that data breach that happened with AT&T, where 73 million and current and former customers' information ended up out there on the dark web for sale. They recommended that those affected use strong passwords, monitor account activity, and consider credit freezes or fraud alerts from credit bureaus. Aura does all of that for you. And you don't have to download a bunch of different apps just because one company couldn't keep your information secure. I know I value my privacy, and you probably do too. So you can go to aura.com/Brandon to start your 2-week free trial, or use the links down in the description and in the pinned comment. We appreciate Aura for being the sponsor of this video. Back to Helldivers.
Now, one of the best parts about Helldivers is, ironically, killing. It was one time, get over it. In fact, team killing is such an integral part of the game that the devs have repeatedly refused to get rid of it because, quote, it's fucking hilarious. So what we're gonna demonstrate here with our, not Eli, is what it looks like when you team kill your buddy with the SG8. Spoiler alert, you're gonna have to reinforce. Spreading democracy all over the concrete in 3, 2, 1. Oh, God. Yeah. Some spray on that one. Dude, noggin empty. That completely blew the skull out of the head. That is disgusting.
Isn't team killing hilarious?
It genuinely was one time. That is vile.
That is the best ballistic dummy headshot I've ever seen.
Just the temporary cavity is ridiculous. So let's go over the manual of arms. For one, you have an AR-15 style pistol grip here. I think it's pretty interchangeable. It looks interchangeable with any other AR-15 pistol grip. That's pretty good because this one that comes with the shotgun feels remarkably small and just shitty. But above that, we have an AR-15 style selector. So you have safe, fire, basically just the same as an AR-15 selector switch. No full auto because it's a fucking pump action. And no, you can't slam fire it. Be a lot cooler if you could. So real quick, show and clear, breech is open. Closing, empty chamber. When there is a round in the chamber, when the gun has been pumped, obviously the pump is locked, so you can't pull the trigger while it's out of battery. Something interesting about this gun, I'm not sure if I like. It's honestly pretty sketchy. I'm not touching the pump whatsoever. When you pull the trigger, it unlocks the bolt. So if you had a hang fire, this very plasticky top cover is going to be lacerating your jugular.
Not a great plan.
Anyway, what that's supposed to do, I guess, is just kind of assist with the pump coming back already. But let's say you didn't want to pull the trigger and you wanted to unlock this anyway. I looked for a long time on this thing and could not find it, but it is actually in the very back on the bottom. So you press this and it unlocks your pump as well. So you can use it to clear and not just have to, you know, if you got a round in the chamber that you don't want to fire, you know, find a shoot barrel. Just do it a desk pop because you can't figure out how to clear your fucking shotgun. Like said, our lever here is what determines whether they're feeding from the right side or the left side. There is no button to pop this top cover at all. It's just kind of, you know, I guess held on by tension. So you just pop this up here and you have full access to your bolt assembly and your two tubes from the rear. This is your dust cover that is held in place by a shitty Hobby Lobby magnet. All the pins on this gun are kind of crudely clipped into place.
Yeah.
The Picatinny on this one was so bad that I tried to put an EOTech ESPS-2 on it, and it wouldn't even fit. The plastic Picatinny was out of spec, so. I used this Tacticon armament red dot that they gave us at one of our range days, so thank you to those guys. Great lovers from what I hear. So yeah, that is how you operate the UTS-15. I'm gonna be real with you, Chief. If you're fighting for democracy, you probably want some better guns than this. And you could be the one making some of those guns. Because if you're interested in getting your start in gunsmithing and weapons technology, you can check out SDI.edu down in the links in the description and in the pinned comment for Super Earth. Course. Now, one of the components that Helldivers also adds to shotguns is the incendiary effect. Really useful when fighting bugs. But to replicate that a little bit today with our UTS-15, we have a little bit of dragon's breath that has a little bit of a oomph behind it. Let's go ahead and use it to take out our target. No, the paper, not Eli. There you go. Torching him in 3, 2, 1. I love how we didn't set the target on fire, but we set the railroad tie on fire behind it. Bad boy, no. Oh, that's a spicy little nugget in there. LaCroix to the rescue. Oh, wow. There you go. Not setting Desperado on fire, brought to you by Microtech. Oh, wow.
It's the 4th of July.
Just you see that spread just hitting everywhere. Man, that is the most patriotic shit I've seen all day.
Yeah.
So after spending a full day with it, what do I think of the UTS-15? It's a piece of shit. So when FPS Russia did a video on this years ago, that's the only experience that I really had with the UTS-15. I've never shot one or anything like that. So like going into this, that's the only thing I could draw from as far as what to think about it. In that video, he had 3 UTS-15s on site available to film with. He needed all 3 because 2 of them broke or went down while filming. So we babied this today. We made sure we weren't too rough with it. If we had any sort of failure or whatever, we didn't just beat it open because we were worried it would break, because this is very, very plasticky. I mean, like, you can physically see, you can grab the sides of the shotgun, and I'm not pushing that hard at all. Like, it is just very, yeah, it feels like shitty plastic is what it feels like. Like your dust cover here, that's despicable. And even though we babied it a bit, we still did have malfunctions.
I'm scared. I'm gonna break this fucking thing. Yeah, that doesn't feel sturdy at all.
There you go.
No.
It would be impossible to make this video on a dual tube magazine fed bullpup shotgun and not compare it to the KSG-12, because this is a direct comparison. It's the same picture, just fucking worse. Despite the fucking bulk, they're the exact same weight, I found out. And as much as we give Kel-Tec shit for, you know, all the cheap washed up Florida beach plastic that they recycle and make their guns out of, it still feels way more solid than this fucking thing. This thing genuinely feels like it is an airsoft chassis to a shotgun. As the best comparison I can make. As a joke, I was gonna drop it, but I was genuinely afraid to break it. So yes, if you want to do Helldiver LARP, get a UTS-15. If you want a 12-gauge shotgun for literally any fucking purpose, KSG-12, much better choice. And I'm real fucking confident the KSG-12 came out before that, and then somehow they just didn't take any fucking notes and came out with that thing. To sum it all up, it's a Turkish shotgun that put looks above function, and it looks very cool, and it functions like a quadruple amputee on a swim team. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the UTS-15 shotgun, aka the SG-8 from Helldivers 2. I would like to give a special thank you to my friends and fellow co-hosts of the Unsubscribed Podcast, Eli Double Tap and Donut Operator, for joining me in this video. So thank you guys very much. You guys want to go home and play some Helldivers?
Hell yeah, brother.
Awesome.
Let's do this thing.
I will see you sexy YouTube mother lovers in the next video.
20. Go.
20 what? Huh? What? Huh?
That's the year Helldivers set. 2185, and we're still using buckshot.
2185 is when they finally figured out how to make this thing run right. See you guys.
Full democracy! Fuel is my obsession to make the perfect weapon. Like us, Putin's rise to the top. Papa Kala, you can stop, can stop, can stop, can stop, can stop, can stop.
Gotta wash it off after all the, look at just the bloody condoms again. Again, bloody condom in your brain. Perhaps not 100% anatomically correct, but it, I don't know where I was going with that.